Tory Lanez was sentenced yesterday to 10 years in prison for shooting Megan Thee Stallion in the foot after leaving a party back in 2020. Had pled not guilty, Lanez that is, was found guilty by a jury this back in December on 3 felony charges. Assault with a semi-automatic firearm, carrying a loaded unregistered firearm in a vehicle, and discharging a firearm with gross negligence. Now, this is an interesting story, not just for the legal developments, but the sort of like public relations developments. So initially, Megan Thee Stallion's real name, told police that she'd cut her feet on glass, but when she was being treated for it, they found bullet fragments in her foot that required surgery. She eventually revealed that she had been sort of, I guess, protecting him by lying about what had happened, and said that she had suffered gunshot wounds that required surgery. She eventually identified that he was the shooter, had been arrested, charged with concealing a firearm, by the way. Here is a video of her with Gail King of CBS discussing the events.
And all I hear is this man screaming, he said, "Dance, bitch." And he starts shooting. And I'm just like, oh my God. Like, he shot a couple of times. Mm-hmm. And I was so scared.
So is he in the car shooting from the car, Megan?
He is standing up over the window, okay, shooting. Uh-huh.
So the situation that she sketches out is like almost inconceivable outside of a movie, like a bad old Western of a person risking killing someone to prove a point, or God knows what was going through this person's head. But the thing that I found amazing, and look, everyone in the audience is gonna be shocked to know that I did not know the details of this story in detail. I'm weirdly disconnected from what goes on around music, but that nobody seemed to believe her, that like people were literally making songs about how she was lying, despite the fact that she had had bullet fragments surgically removed from her foot. I know that in America, you know, women are assumed to be liars, particularly when they are making claims against notable men, but that part of the story just seems so wild to me, Jessica.
Absolutely, yeah. It's a really sad situation that there are still so many people who initially defended Tory Lanez who have been pretty much silent, even though we had so much evidence come about in court that made it very obvious that Tory Lanez was guilty of shooting Meg. And the way this went down, that it was far before she became as famous as she is today. So the fact that people would say that she is using this to gain fame or notoriety, that for some reason any woman has ever had a successful career because she spoke out about an act of violence committed against her by a man who's famous about her, that has literally never happened. Megan Thee Stallion is famous now because she's very good at making music and she's a very good rapper. And now there are probably some more people on her side, but the way we had to go through a full trial of this, not only was she tried in the court of public opinion, he was tried in the court of public opinion and had most people on his side. Imagine coming up as a musician when people think you're lying about an established rapper, and the way he's saying dance speaks to the entitlement he felt because he was more famous than her. And so the whole situation is super absurd. It's a good example for us to learn from, hopefully, of what it's like to be a Black woman in America and speak out about an act of violence committed against you.
Yeah, 100%. And to know that for both of those reasons, both for being a woman and for being Black, you're probably generally, when you make claims of this sort, you're going to be assumed to be a liar, even if the evidence is on your side. You know, there's been multiple high profile instances of that over the last year or two. But in terms of the 10 years, the prosecution was seeking 13 years. She says she couldn't walk for a while. She still has nerve damage. She can't feel the side of her left foot, which, you know, that could have an effect on a performing artist's ability to do their job. Remember that it was multiple charges, and also a person who would do that, like what is the gap that we're supposed to have mentally between that and a person who would just shoot her literally in the chest? Like, he's obviously comfortable with the possibility that she will die as a result of what he is alleged to have done. So I don't know, I would be very worried about that. And I understand why they took it so seriously when we finally got to the sentencing of this. Anyway, any final thoughts before we move on?
I've seen Twitch streamers like Aiden Ross have Tory Lanez come on their stream. And it's the type of guy that also embraces Andrew Tate. And it's just very weird to me that the motto for a lot of these manosphere type spaces, these very right-wing misogynistic spaces, it's not just, you know, we're against feminism and we're against the message that empowers women. It's we're embracing men that commit acts of violence against women, that they like that. It's more than just being against equality. They want people to hurt women. And that's really scary that this has become really obvious as a part of this, just the embrace and defense of Tory Lanez by that community.
100%. Yeah, they at the very least want other people to hurt women because they hate and despise and lust after women, and they want them to pay for what they believe women have done to them. And a lot of them also want to be the ones doing the hurting, honestly. And everyone just bear in mind, when you see, and like anytime a woman makes a claim like this, there's gonna be a million Twitch streams about it, and there's gonna be a million YouTube videos that get a million views each about it. When these guys say that they don't believe these women, it is an utterly meaningless statement. They don't mistrust. It's not that they don't believe them. They don't care. They don't care if any of these things happen. They don't care if these women are abused or harassed or raped or assaulted or murdered. They don't care if bad things happen to women. They want to see more of that in the world. And then they want to make money along the way off of the suffering being inflicted on women.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.